Hello everyone, my name is Dusty and we're here at the restoration shop. And right behind me is our M48 AVLB bridge layer. Now what we want to show you guys is part of our restoration process of the bridge itself. What we're going to do is we're going to bring that bridge into the shop so we can tear it apart, make the repairs that are necessary. So let's go join the crew and get this thing started.
She drives a little different with 30,000 pounds on top of her.
Wing overhead.
Well, we've already done an external restoration and paint job on the launcher since our first video that you guys may have seen. And if you haven't seen that video, I would encourage you guys to go back and look that one up. Part of the reason we're bringing the bridge into the shop is so that we can disassemble it and paint it so it'll match the launcher and the chassis.
We've got the forklift out here. We've blocked up the end of the bridge so we can get the forks under there a little bit further. And we're gonna walk this thing in.
I think that's probably good there, guys.
I think we're good there.
The next step is separating the bridge into two halves, which requires removing the scissor cylinder, the component that unfolds the bridge during deployment.
We've already pulled this pin out, which attaches the equalizer plate to the cylinder. The next step is to remove an identical pin right here that has been holding us hostage due to the fact that it hasn't probably been removed in over 30 years, and we're also dealing with some dissimilar metal corrosion.
This is the pin that's going to decide how quickly or how slowly we can move forward. The air chisels aren't getting us where we need to be. At this point, the only option is to remove the surrounding hardware so the entire cable assembly can come off. That will allow us to take it to the press and apply more force to remove the pin.
All these bolts are loose. You just have a safety pin on them so that the bridge can flex and not break.
When we remove this assembly, we have to be very careful not to damage them because they have to be a matched set. If one cable is stretched and one cable is not, it could affect the geometry when we try to deploy the bridge.
With the pin still holding, the entire assembly comes off so it can go to the press.
So we just pulled the pins from here with the bridge pivots on, and that's going to allow us to remove this fulcrum here. This pin and this pin, and then one on outboard on each side is our final step to separating the bridge. As soon as those are out, we are in two pieces. But we've got hydraulic lines running through the bridge that we have to disconnect before we can separate this.
So this is going to be some wet work. We should have just a little bit of a residual pressure here. These oil lines technically run our scissor cylinder. We have some splinting. We're all capped and plugged out.
The next step is removing the remaining four pins so the bridge can be disconnected. We'll use a hydraulic pump to apply more force and push them out. With those pins removed, the bridge can finally be separated into two halves.
Go ahead. Okay. Okay, we just got the last pin out and we are officially ready to separate the bridge halves. That's how you separate a bridge.
Up there? Okay.
With the bridge separated, one half is returned to storage, and attention turns to the remaining half.
Over the time and the years, this bridge has showed some fatigue, and some of the brackets are starting to structurally crack. This piece here should look like this piece up here above us. This has been cracked when this stress broke out. Somebody tried to weld this in, which is a no-no on the bridge. We cannot weld on them due to the alloy of the aluminum. And so removing the whole arrangement, the scissor cylinder there, and putting it on this end of the bridge so we don't have to repair the brackets that are cracking.
The next step is to remove the scissor cylinder from this section of the bridge.
That's solid.
Okay, so we're not moving that real easy, so we're gonna force it with some hydraulics. We can probably push maybe 5 ton against this pin. Then we will use our air chisels here against these ears to cause a vibration, hopefully release that and push it out.
Whoa.
Hold it there for a second.
Whoa. Okay, we're at about 2,500 right there.
Okay. Are you ready on your side?
This pin on one end of the scissor cylinder isn't moving. We've tried hydraulic pressure, heat, and air hammers, and nothing has worked. At this point, we need to apply more heat and see if we can break it free.
Nothing.
Nothing, honey.
We've got it hot enough that the pin is also now swelled. We've made it kind of worse now.
The next step is to apply even more heat and melt wax around the joint. After that, we'll let it cool and see if it helps break the pin free.
As the pin cools, the wax works its way back even in a press fit joint, and it'll wick its way all the way to the hot end. Same as when they solder plumbing together. That's what we're going to try to achieve with this wax. The plan of attack this morning is to reheat fast and throw the porter power up in and jack her out.
I think we're gonna have to cut it out. So this is a lancing rod. Copper on the outside, it's got magnesium on the inside. And then once I pull the trigger, I've got a striker plate that I'll touch this to, and it'll light the rod. And then I'll go into the hole and then go at the end of the pin, and it'll start blowing all the molten steel away. Since we have to go through the wall to get to the pin, we're gonna have to put two rods together in order to reach it.
I'm ready. Tell me when to pull the trigger.
Pull trigger!
This is part of the pin.
It's happening. Let's go. Hold it, Mike.
I got it.
You broke it, Bob.
Man, that was tough. That pin did not want to come out, but we finally got it. And as you can see, we've got our cylinder out. Now our next step is we're going to take this section of the bridge, we're going to load it onto the trailer that we custom built, and we're going to move it into our wash basin. Well, that concludes our first episode of the restoration of our AVLB. But stay tuned, because in our next episode, we're going to show you the rest of the restoration process. So if you like this content, please like and subscribe. I'm Dusty, and I will see you guys on the next one.